It is time to start learning about one of the most important open source packages in Python, and that's called NumPy. It is an open source project aiming to enable very efficient numeric computing with arrays. If you scroll down the website a little bit, you see its main features. It provides powerful any-dimension arrays for numeric computing. It also offers plenty of functions to deal with linear algebra and math in general. It is fast, easy to use, and most importantly, it is free. If you scroll down a little bit more, you see the general picture of NumPy and its usage in the scientific domain. It is used for quantum computing, statistical computing, signal processing, 3D visualization, and so on. When it comes to data science, machine learning, and data visualization, you end up using libraries that consume NumPy arrays. This course will be presented using Jupyter Notebook. If you have no idea what a Jupyter Notebook is, I do have a video covering the four steps and how to install it and how to get started with that. I'll let the link in the description if you're interested. However, I won't say that you don't need to use it. You can very well use your IDE or text editor of your preference and follow the video. In this introductory video, I will show you the power of NumPy library. I will also show you how to install it, and then you'll learn how to create vectors and matrices, or one-dimensional and two-dimensional arrays. Then we'll discuss about why using NumPy arrays rather than Python list when dealing with math. And finally, we will perform a speed test comparing the performance of a NumPy array over a Python list. Let's get started. NumPy does not come built-in with Python. We need to install it. To install it, we just go to the official website and you see that we have two options. The first one is if you're using Anaconda. In your root environment, you already have NumPy, but in case you create a new environment, then you need to open the conda terminal and type conda install NumPy. If you're like me, not using Anaconda, then you should use the pip package management. You just open your terminal, type pip install numpy. To check if you have access to the library, you just need to type import numpy as mp. Then, when you execute the cell, if you get no error, it means that you have it. Perfect. Now, how to get started? You need to know that numpy is based on that thing called nd array. An nd array is a class. And each object created from this class is referred to be a NumPy array. You're gonna hear people say NumPy array or array. They are exactly the same thing. If you don't understand what is a class or object-oriented programming, that's no problem at all. You just need to understand that we use arrays to create vectors and matrices. And what is a vector? A vector is a one-dimensional array. And a matrix is a two-dimensional array. And a tensor is a three-dimensional array, and so on. And how to create those arrays? Well, there are different ways to do that, and the simplest one is using a numerical Python sequence, and that could be a list or a tuple. Let me show you. Here, I have a variable called temperature list, and then I assign to that variable a list. As values, I give 18.5, 20, and 25. Now, how to create an array out of that list? You just need to type np.array, then open and close parentheses, and now you give the list. Which list? Temperature list. If I execute it, the first line is the list itself and the type list. Then we get the array and the type nd array. And again, the nd array is that class I told you before. Let's create a 2D array. As I want to create a matrix, what you need to do, you need to create a nested list. If you don't know what is a nested list, it is just a list inside another list. Now we are creating another NumPy array, so we just type NumPy array and then give a list and we assign that to matrix. If I execute it, we get the matrix. And look, the type is also nd array. Maybe you're asking yourself, why should you use NumPy array rather than list? Well, NumPy arrays are much more efficient than list when you want to deal with math. And the first difference I want to show you is the following. List can contain elements of any data type, while a NumPy array can only have a unique data type. In this example, I assign a list to a variable called temperature list, and the first element is a float, and the second element is an integer. Then, using that list, we create an array. We just type np.array, then give that list as argument. Then I assign that NumPy array to a variable called temperature array. What I want to print is the type of the first and second element. If you remember, indexing in Python starts with 0. If I execute that cell, you see that the first element of this list is a float, and the second element is an integer. But when we create a NumPy array out of that list, we no longer have a float and an integer. Both elements are floats. When calling the NumPy array function, we can provide a second argument, and that argument is called dtype, which stands for data type. Now, if I set that to be an integer, all elements inside of that array will be converted to integer. Let me just execute that code. If I check for the type, we get integer and integer. It's important to know that NumPy array contains only one data type, and we can specify that data type explicitly when calling the NumPy array function. But normally, you don't need to do that. Then I'll delete it and run the cell again. Let's perform a speed test comparing NumPy arrays and lists when dealing with basic math operation. Let me show you what I want to do. I will just create a new cell, so you press B. Then we create a list, I'll call it X, and I give 1, 2, 3. Then a second list called Y, then I will give 2, 4, and 6. What I want to do in the end is to print X plus Y. But my aim is to add each element of each list element-wise, meaning that I want to get 1 plus 2, 2 plus 4, and 3 plus 6. If I just print X plus Y, as it is a list data type, we are going to get a concatenation. Then we get the first list, X, and the second list, in that case Y, will be appended. And this is not what we want to do. We want to add the list element-wise. Let me just delete that cell. I press D twice. Then, to save us time, I have the code already done here. Basically, in this cell is our input data. I create X and Y list. For this, I'm using a list comprehension. Then, after X and Y are created, I can create our NumPy arrays. I call them X array and Y array. And again, you just need to type np.thefunctionArray and you provide the list. Now, if I execute that code, we get the X list and the Y list. And again, we want to add 0 plus 0, 1 plus 2, and so on. Let's first solve it using list. I'll just comment the first line and print the result. Well, what we are doing here, we create an empty list. Then we use a for loop, and for each iteration, we add the first element of the X list with the first element of the Y list. Then we append that value to this result list, then we print it. If we execute that cell, we get what we want. Perfect. Now, how can I do that using NumPy arrays? Well, if you want to do NumPy array, it is as simple as saying X array plus Y array. We cannot do that with list, but with NumPy array, we can. If I just execute that code, we get the result. But how to compare the performance? For that, we're gonna be using a magic comment called timeIt. What it does, it times the execution time of that cell. For that, let me just comment the print comment. If not, we're gonna get a lot of print statement and we don't want that. I'll run that code and explain what is going on. What that timeIt does, it executes that cell 1 million times, then it shows the average of the execution time and the standard deviation. Let's just use the average number. Let me just time the X array execution. Then we can compare the results. Okay, our list time was 1.41 microseconds. Okay, that's all right. And our NumPy array took 381 nanoseconds. Then nano is minus 9. If I execute that code, I see that Python list is almost 4 times slower. But what about if you increase that number? Let's say that our dataset has 1000 numbers. Well, that was not that smart because I just let the print statement here, right? Let me just execute it again. Now I run again the benchmark for the least solution. Then we execute again the NumPy solution. Now let's compare. The first one is 114 microseconds, that's right. And the NumPy array took now 1.32 microseconds. If I execute it, the performance of a list is 86 times slower than array. The larger is the number of elements, the worse is the performance of list compared with array. I hope now you understand why NumPy arrays is so much used in the scientific community. In the next video, we'll learn how to perform operations with NumPy arrays and get to know useful NumPy functions. I'll also tell you how to inspect the entire NumPy library and get additional information of any function or method you're interested in. Finally, we'll practice everything we learned so far and solve mathematical formulas and series. If you have a special request for this series, let me know in the comments section. Thanks for watching.